Gervonta Davis. You were supposed to fight him. It sold more tickets out here than any fight in the history of StubHub. Unfortunately, an injury happened the week of the fight. It happens. It's boxing. But ever since you called him out, no one called him out before. I know that for a fact.
Yeah.
Because to me, Gervonta was the most avoided fighter in boxing. Maybe still is.
Thank you, Elie. Thank you. Yeah, thank you, bro. And that's something I like to bring out to everybody's attention. And not, I think it will. If I say it, if it comes out of me, people are going to say, ah, you're full of it. But, you know, you're right. You're saying it. And it's true. Nobody wanted a piece of it. Nobody wanted to fight him. You know, they were scared. And all of a sudden, I call him out. You know, fight happens. And you're right. We oversold. And when I say oversold at StubHub, we're talking about they had to add bleachers, bro. Bleachers in the front. I remember I got the call from my advisor, like, Abner, this is big. You know, we're adding bleachers because, you know, we're overselling tickets. You know, people want to see this fight. You know, and then unfortunately, you know, I got injured. But, you know, a fight never happened. And now we see everybody calling him out. Everybody wants to accuse of Tank Davis.
No.
And I don't blame him. You know, I don't blame him. He's a big name.
He's a big name. He's explosive. I'm thinking when people call him out, they would call him out and then go the other way. Like, it's cool, like, oh, I'd fight him, but really, they're not interested. When you called him out, the fight was signed, and I was excited for that fight. But Leonard Ellerbe said this week that after the pandemic, Gervonta Davis is fighting Leo. You know Leo very well. You've known him from L.A. You fought him a couple times. How do you think Gervonta Davis, Leo Santa Cruz pans out?
I've said that it has a lot to do with two things. The weight and the conditioning either of these fighters come in. If they fight at 130 and Tank Davis is not fully prepared for that fight, I think Leo takes it for, you know, many reasons. Number one, 130, it's super hard for Tank to make. We all seen him struggle making 130. That's what the reason why he moved to 135. So if they make him go dehydrate himself to 130, that's an advantage for Leo. And the second one, if he doesn't train properly, as we saw with Gamboa, you know, he got tired, bro. And he was still getting tagged by a tired, you know, torn Achilles, older Gamboa. Imagine a Leo that's, you know, strong, that always walks forward, and he's a volume puncher. So I think he can do damage. So I think that's the only reason, and that's the only way Leo can win. But if the fight is at, you know, a catch weight and Tank is in top shape, I see Tank taking the fight by knockout, by stoppage. Maybe not knockout, but stoppage.
Obviously, Tank 23-0, 22 knockouts. He's a two-division champion, three-time champ. Leo Santa Cruz, a four-division champ, throws punches in bunches. Where do you rate, like, Leo's power?
Being real, he's not a big power guy. You know, that's why most of our fights and, you know, his fights have, you know, gone distance and always and to be entertaining, because you can sit there, you know, comfortably in the pocket and trade punches. And make it exciting, for, you know, for that simple fact, you know, that he's not a big hitter.
So that would be a big, interesting fight. Another one, Ryan Garcia, he's doing phenomenally well. Abner, I don't know if you know this, but Ryan just passed 6 million followers on Instagram, and that is sensational.
Yeah, no, I did not know that, bro. And I just know that for a fact he's one of the biggest names in social media out there, you know, regardless of him being a fighter. He just... what's the word I'm looking for? Marketable. He's really marketable. Young kid, you know.
He's
young, good-looking kid. He speaks well. He knows how to, you know, interact with the world, you know, with everyone. And everybody loves him, bro. And I think he's a good thing for boxing. A lot of people, you know, give him shit, obviously, because he still hasn't done, and it's true, he still hasn't done anything in boxing. He's barely starting. But, you know, this is the type of kids and names we need in boxing to take it to another level. You know, we want to bring in a different crowd into the boxing world, you know, and that's what they're doing. And that's what this kid and the Tank Davis and you know, the David Haney's are doing. They're the future of boxing.
That's true. And you got Teofimo Lopez is 22 years old. David Benavidez, 22 years old. Virgil Ortiz, 22 years old. So out of all the 35 big names, you have... Gervonta, you have Lomachenko, you have Devin Haney, Ryan, just those four. I know I'm missing a couple others. So there you have it, another great video for ES News. For ESNewsReporting.com, I'm Elie Seckbach reporting, and you can follow me on Twitter at Seckbach, and you can follow me on Instagram at Elie Seckbach.